Hey gang, what's up? Welcome back here to another edition of Intuitive Angling, and thanks a lot for checking today's video out. Much appreciated. And guys, today we're going to be talking about some of the companies out there that have sort of gotten the habit of knocking off some of the other companies' designs. This is going on a lot right now, the last year or so like that, so we're going to dig into that, give you guys my opinion, and I'd be curious to know what you guys think about that too. So. Hey guys, real quick before we get started, I just want to invite everybody out there, if you haven't had a chance, just to please consider subscribing to Intuitive Angling here, the channel, and my other channel, The Fishing Teacher with Randy Blockett. If you subscribe, you get notifications, don't miss any videos. And right now, 60% of everybody that watches my videos are not subscribed to the channel, so it's a good way to support what's going on here if you just click that subscribe button. It's free and easy, so much appreciated. Okay guys, I wanted to do this video in light of the fact that, you know, there was the ICAST show, the big international sport fishing show down in Orlando last week. I didn't get a chance to go to it, but in this particular show, if you're not familiar with it, it's, you know, a lot of the tackle manufacturing companies across the country introduce new products to the, it's not open to the public, it's open to the fishing industry. And one of the reasons I am doing this video, guys, is you cannot believe how many people sent me messages that attended ICAST this year to say, Randy, you cannot believe some of these companies down there, the big well-known companies that you guys know about, big box tackle manufacturing companies that are just blatantly knocking off other companies' designs. So, you know, we're gonna talk about that a little bit. Now, first of all, this has been going on for a while. This is really nothing that's new. And when I'm talking about knocking off designs or what other people are, we're not talking about something like, you know, when Yamamoto came out with the Senko, everybody had a Senko because that's sort of just a simplistic, you know, lure design. It's not really a design, it's just a modification of a worm. Or somebody has a creature bait that, and next year another company has that looks like the same creature bait but puts legs on it or something like that. That's just modifications. We're talking about companies that are knocking off some of the more high-tech design hard bait, glide baits, big swim baits, soft baits, or not soft baits, but the larger type baits. And basically they're doing this for two different reasons. One is they want to capitalize on a market share that they don't have, and they see another company be successful with it. And two, which I really want to get into in this video, it sort of like speaks to the lack of ingenuity and the lack of creativity amongst the companies that are doing this in the bigger picture out there. Now I'll take, for example, guys, Megabass Vision 110. I helped design this bait back in the 90s, and this was a true innovation. There's a big difference between companies copying other things and true innovations in a jerk bait. This was a true innovation in a jerk bait as far as like the internal balancer system, different profiles and that type of stuff. And the Vision 110 has got knocked off by a bunch of different companies. Some companies have knocked it off exactly with one little tiny different in there. Some of them have taken the basic profile and design. Some of them have copied eyes, you know, little bits and pieces there. So that goes on within the industry. But one of the things that I sort of find disturbing is some of these super well-known large companies that have been around forever, they're just blatantly knocking off smaller companies' designs out there. And you guys know who, I'm not gonna, you know, point any fingers out there, but it's pretty obvious, you know, to anyone that follows fishing tackle and follows certain, you know, bait genres and that type of stuff, what's going on. But more than anything else, I just like to find out what you guys think about it. I know that enforcing a patent is extremely hard, because when you're talking about enforcing a patent, like when somebody copies another successful lure design, if they take it to court or something like that, number one, it's extremely expensive, and number two, there's a lot of loopholes in getting by with something, just some little minor difference, like happened when companies started knocking off the Megabass Dark Sleeper. They get away with those little, you know, slight modifications like that. So from that standpoint, it's not illegal. I don't even think you call it unethical. Some people would call it smart business. Some people would call it, again, lack of creativity and lack of ingenuity. But ultimately what happens is when you have a company, say for example, like Megabass, that is a truly innovative company that comes up with new designs that are unique to the industry, and then you have other companies that basically are known for copying other people and their followers are not leaders, I think that undermines the credibility of those companies a little bit. And I know a lot of those companies will be able to produce the knockoff versions cheaper. And ultimately, it's probably just about making money. But anyway, more than anything else, I'd just be curious to hear your guys' opinion on this. Do you guys think this is right? What's your opinion of the companies that knock off some of the other companies' products out there? And like I said, it's been going on a long time. It's not, there's nothing new about it with that. So anyway, throw me some feedback. Hope you guys are doing good. We'll talk later.